Ladies and gentlemen, we are literally hours and days away from the first votes being cast in the 2024 general elections for the big decision on who's going to run the country for the next 5 years. The years have rolled by, the months have rolled by, the weeks have rolled by. You pretty much now heard the best case scenarios, the best arguments, the best positioning, the best report cards, the best vision plans, and the best of the manifestos that the political parties could come up with. You've heard, in essence, that it is an election during the era of a Narendra Modi, and it is an election that is going to ask you, in the scientifically established wisdom of the crowd, what do you feel? What was done well? What needs to be done better? Who's the man with the plan for the next 5 years? At this stage, only one thing now matters for all of us. The politicians have their careers at stake. For us, it's simply about who is winning in 2024. Over the course of this special telecast, we now examine that question with a poll survey, state by state, region by region, and then bring you a national picture to get you a perspective of what the pollsters say is happening at this point of time. Mayank Singh joining us on the broadcast, who has helped put together the survey that we are going to be showing you in just a few minutes. Mayank ji, before we go through the data, help us understand what was the methodology, over what period of time, how did you set up in going about getting the pulse data that you compiled?
Right. We started from 4th of Jan this year, and we started from north of India, and the entire duration of our survey was around 100 days. So we started from north, then we took data from west, and then we went towards east, and then we covered northeast, and after that, lastly, we covered south of India. So the sample size that we have collected, we were keeping this thing in mind that we have to collect somewhere around 600 to 650 data per Lok Sabha seat. So this was our first priority. And that's how it took little longer for us to conduct the entire survey. So we conducted the survey. 75% of the survey was done on ground and 25% was done through CBT. CBT is computer-based telephonic interviews. So we had set of questions, and the kind of questions we asked that kept on changing when we are changing the zone and the states. So for different state, we had different set of questions. So somewhere around 10 questions to 12 questions we generally asked, and that was all the questions were like close-ended questions, and we had few ratings questions as well. So doing all this analysis, we came with data, and the data collected that also after all those heavy we can say file, after collecting all those data and segregating all those data, we have conducted the entire survey.
All right, so Mayank ji, obviously what we are going to be telecasting and showcasing now is the headline figures, okay? You'll have had plenty of time to go through the data as it's coming in. So with your team, a deeper understanding. Now, without specifically going into the final figure, what is the trend that is getting established in various regions and in the country? What is the data telling you? Is it a pretty solid trend? Is it pretty weak? Can we be more emphatic about how this is going? What is your gut telling you as a scientist, data scientist, in analyzing the data?
See, before I tell you more about that, one thing that I want to tell you, that we even started with a sample survey, and after that we started doing surveys in such places wherein few issues came up in between, like in West Bengal after the Sandesh Kali event, and in Delhi after the arrest of Arvind Kejriwal. Then we started getting tracker samples as well. So after that, what we can see is BJP is comfortably keeping its bastion, that is north of India, Gujarat, and they are making inroads in south of India. I mean, I think that as per our survey, the findings from south of India will be a big surprise for BJP and all of us, because they are making the vote share, they are making somewhere around 14 to 15% in Tamil Nadu, and in Kerala the vote share is what we are predicting would be somewhere around 21%. So that's massive jump for a party like BJP. Even though there were few states wherein even now, like Punjab, Kerala, Tamil Nadu, the choice of PM, there was one set of question what we asked, like whom you want to see as a PM of this country, and most of the people in Tamil Nadu, Kerala and Punjab, surprisingly, they were vouching for Rahul Gandhi and not Narendra Modi.
Okay, all right, quickly. So this was seat by seat, as you said. So every constituency has been surveyed. This is not a generic impression taken from an area or a district.
Right.
Okay, so seat by seat. So the seat by seat data is also available with Mayankji. We'll be telecasting it. Our sister channel, in fact, India News, is telecasting it as we speak, where, of course, Mayankji will be available live in just a few minutes. Let's get out. Mayankji, thank you for joining us. And Thanks. We will come back and now analyze the data. But what matters is, can we see it, please? Let's have it on your screen, starting from the north and working our way through the various states. In Jammu and Kashmir, for the seats that are up for grabs, five of them, remember, Ladakh is a separate entity now. Two for the BJP, assuming Jammu, NC gets three. So something to hope for Omar Abdullah in Jammu and Kashmir, in the Kashmir Valley. Zero for the Congress, zero for the PDP. Going across to Ladakh, where there is a single seat held by the BJP, the survey indicates, yes, indeed, the BJP will continue holding it. In the national capital of New Delhi, seven seats available, swept by the BJP, seven out of seven last time. The D-Dynamic poll this time around says six for the BJP, one for the Aam Aadmi Party, zero for the Congress. Remember, the AAP and the Congress in an alliance, 4-by-3 seat sharing plan. They've come up for it. Maybe the Aam Aadmi Party sneaks in one at this point of time. Then the big one, Uttar Pradesh, 80 seats up for grabs. 73, says the D-Dynamic poll survey, for the Bharatiya Janata Party. Two for Jayant Chaudhary's RLD. Two for Apna Dal, 73 plus 2 plus 2, that is 77 out of 80 seats. The balance three going to Akhilesh Yadav of the Samajwadi Party, leaving the Congress and the BSP with a fat total of zero in the biggest state of the country. Unhappy news, of course, for the Congress, but the BJP will be hoping, having swept the state twice in two general elections, they need those numbers. And UP they're going to be counting on, so they'll be hoping this is absolutely true. In Madhya Pradesh, where the government has just flipped once again in a state election, 29 seats, 28 for the Bharatiya Janata Party, one for the Congress. It is a sweep being predicted by this poll. In Chhattisgarh, where also the government has switched 11 seats, 10 for the BJP, one for the Congress. The poll says it's going to be a sweep. In Haryana, 10 seats available, 8 says the poll for the Congress, 8 for the BJP, 2 for the Congress. So a near sweep for the BJP, where in Haryana they might have been edgy. Well, the polls are indicating they will do better than even most people expect, which will be happy news because it's a state they want to sweep. In Uttarakhand, 5 seats available, 5 out of 5, says the survey for the Bharatiya Janata Party, nothing for the Congress. In Punjab, where the BJP has not had a large footprint in the past, have a look at this. BJP 4, Shiromani Akali Dal 2, Aam Aadmi Party 2, Congress 5. Remember, Aam Aadmi Party in power in the state, Congress previously in power in the state. Yet it is 50-50 because the seat-sharing alliance is not in tune between the AAP and Congress in Punjab. So the SAD, a former partner in many ways, maybe gets 2, the BJP gets 4. In Himachal, where the Congress government is in power, the survey says they won't win a single Lok Sabha seat. But now this is where the battle between Vikramaditya and Kangana is going on in this state. So now, ladies and gentlemen, for the entire north of India, there are 161 seats in the north of India in the states we have considered, of which the NDA, led by the BJP, secures 139. The Indy Alliance secures 22. Let me open up this conversation. Alok Mehta joining us in the studios. We have Joyta Basu with us in the studios. Manasvi Thapar joining us. Deshratan Nigam joining us. Alok ji, quick thoughts on the North India numbers.
I think it's quite close to what we are feeling at that moment. Because, you know, it's too early to predict what will happen in next 1 month. But even then, I think this pollster, he did very well, because a very big number Normally, survey depend on the how many people you contacted. I think this kind of survey is a very close. Maybe some here or there, they're like Delhi. I still doubt there's one Aam Aadmi Party will win. Or in Haryana, Congress will win. Maybe Bhupen Singh Hooda or family, if they contest, then it's easy. Otherwise, very difficult in Haryana also. So these kind of some error, maybe this or that, are in UP, it's very quite close.
Okay. Okay.
So I feel these figures are very close to expected.
Okay. Okay. UP, I mean, twice around, they've, you know, 65, 70, yes. 75, that's what you want. You want to sweep the state. Joyta, let's look at Kashmir, for example. The big twist in the tale, of course, is that the survey says, yes, the Omar Abdullah in the Kashmir Valley, while Mehbooba Mufti might be wiped out, this might work because the Congress is going to aid and abet it, and they might win three seats. Omar Abdullah is going to be back in parliament.
Yeah, it looks like that. Omar Abdullah is fighting from Baramulla. And Mehbooba Mufti, one of the reasons why they fielded Mehbooba Mufti from Anantnag was that they were expecting that, you know, PDP is going to be wiped out. But it seems that, you know, NC candidate is very strong over there in Anantnag. So when we are looking at the three seats, obviously all these three seats are coming from the valley, which means Srinagar, Anantnag and Baramulla. And Anantnag, of course, BJP has brought in two constituencies from Jammu. So possibly it is not going to help the BJP, but yes, I would say it is kind of on expected lines that yes, Omar Abdullah is back
This is what it was last time around. Okay, Manas, we come in on this. Let's discuss Jammu, Kashmir, Ladakh, of course, separated. Lots of troubles happening in Ladakh, by the way, right now. Okay, there's a massive agitation that Sonam Bangchuk agitation has been going on. But the polls say no, the BJP retains the seat, but yes, the NC still has a hold on the valley. They might come back.
See, Sonam Bangchuk is there, but I don't think that is going to make an impact on the voters' base, because what has touched the people is the peace in the valley. That is something which has touched in Ladakh also. This is the first kind of election after Article 370. So there is nothing which is negative on the BJP side. Though NC is there, though Mehbooba Mufti would be there, but these things are not a major factor which could damage BJP's new juggernaut, which is going to be presented in Jammu Kashmir region. So that's something which is a new norm, I would say now. So it is not very easy to take out BJP from there. Why? Because they may not have the local leaders there, but the factor of Prime Minister Narendra Modi is much bigger than any local leader which would come from the region. Okay. So this is very important, because the people are more connected with the national figure than with the local figure. That's the changing factor, which is a missing factor for all the other political
parties. Okay, let's jump across. Deshnath Nigam, let's jump across into Punjab, where the BJP does not traditionally have a large footprint. We saw that in the assembly elections. We saw that in the Lok Sabha elections. A lot of change in Punjab. Amrinder Singh is now in the BJP. The Aam Aadmi Party for the first time is in power in the state. But the survey here says between them and the Shiromani Akali Dal, maybe six seats.
Yes. In fact, Rishabh, if you look at the utter failure of the, you know, farmers' agitation, so-called farmers' agitation was an indicator that this time there is going to be a change around. And especially the Lok Sabha election, the assembly elections are fought on a different parameters. And Captain Amrinder Singh and Sunil Jakhar, both two stalwarts representing different sections of the society, have joined BJP. So I'm expecting, a good fortune for BJP. And probably Congress and AAP will eat into each other's votes, because they don't see eye to eye, and that benefit will go to BJP and SAD.
Okay.
And that probably, I think, is an indication, a bright indication for
Okay, Manasvi, let's jump in into the ironic one in Himachal Pradesh. Now, Himachal Pradesh, we've seen a lot of politics happen over the Rajya Sabha polls just recently. Okay, it was a marginal victory. A victory is a victory. Marginal victory or not, but it was a marginal victory for the Congress. Little bit of disruption, little bit of, there's a Kangana factor now for some reason in the state as well. The survey says, but it's a sweep for the BJP. How come?
See, not belt when it comes to selecting the Prime Minister or electing the Prime Minister, it's a common phenomena. What we understand in 2024 is, it is Prime Minister Narendra Modi, and there's no one in terms of the national figure who could match to his charisma. That's a taken factor in 2024. I don't think there is any other factor which is more important in this election. The central figure of this election, be it for the opposition or for the BJP, is Modi. And even Modi knows that, understands it very well. The Prime Minister says this manifesto is not about BJP ki guarantee, it's about Modi ki guarantee. So that's the connecting factor. Even in Himachal or you take Gujarat, Rajasthan, the connecting factor is that this particular central figure is larger than life. People would trust him, people would vote for him.
Okay.
So the vote is not going for the local leader or the local MP. They are electing the Prime Minister. They are not even thinking they are electing Kangana or not Kangana. They are electing the Prime Minister. This is the mindset.
All right, quickly, Deshradhanam, on Delhi. Now, we've seen the irony in Delhi, of course, which is the opposite, which says that the Aam Aadmi Party swept in the state elections. It did exceedingly well in the municipal elections. But in the Lok Sabha elections, 100% went for the Bharatiya Janata Party. Now, there's a bit of a rejig. Gautam Gambhir no longer contesting. Baswari Swaraj has come in. There is a deal between the Aam Aadmi Party and the Congress, so they won't be cutting each other's votes. And many people have argued that the one place where the BJP, for some reason, doesn't seem to have its entire machinery sorted, maybe Delhi is it. So what do you suspect for Delhi?
Rishabh, in fact, that question has always, you know, troubled BJP, even in 2014 election and 2019 elections, that the one face that BJP could give to Delhi as a CM has not been there. But despite that, they have been sweeping. So that question is immaterial so far as Lok Sabha elections are concerned. Mr. Modi's name, the grassroots connect that the workers have and the booth level workers, I believe that all seven seats will go to the BJP. And Delhi will set an example. You know, the different voting pattern we have seen in the assembly and the municipal elections,
yes,
does not match with the Lok Sabha elections.
Okay.
So at the end of the day, let me tell you, they will eat into each other's votes. They don't see eye to eye. Even their tall leaders also don't see eye to eye.
Of course, they don't see eye to eye. Aam Aadmi Party destroyed the Congress in Delhi. It's 15 years of Sheila Dikshit's rule. It's very ironical to see Sandeep Dikshit protesting outside his residence. But
and liquor
need,
scam. And,
need
and
of the hour. Is, need of the hour. Politics is about scam. Need of the hour.
Liquor scam is also on account of the first complaint.
But like
Congress.
I said, it's going to be a dramatic election. I want to see the voter turnout in Delhi come 3 weeks from now. Okay, does the arrest of Arvind Kejriwal get more people out in larger numbers? And what do they think? Do they think that he's, you know, there's fire where there is smoke? Or do you think, or they think he's a victim and therefore gets a lot of sympathy vote? Interesting election in the national capital. Remember, seven seats and every seat matters in this vote. Don't discount it. Alok ji, let's come to the big one. UP in 2019, 80 seats. The BJP got 62, the Apna Dal 2. The BSP got 10 with their allies and independents, 15 together. The SP had 5, the RLD had 0, the Congress had just 1. This time the BSP, says the poll, wiped out to 0. The Congress wiped out to 0, won't even win a single one. I'm assuming that they now mean that the Sonia Gandhi seat will also be lost, which of course is going to be a big ticket item. And the Samajwadi Party stays where it is. Your thoughts?
I think in Rae Bareli, if Priyanka Gandhi go there, certainly there will be an interesting fight. And still, because in Rae Bareli, Amethi, Smriti Irani is very difficult to defeat her. Even the Rahul Gandhi goes there, it will be difficult for Rahul Gandhi too, what I feel. Maybe he go very dynamically and dynamic personality, he think about himself. Otherwise, what I feel the law and order, what Mayawati ji used to get the support from the people, the Yogi Adityanath factor and the Modi. Modi and Mandir, two issue, major issue that the whole UP okay. is dominated totally with like a control from the human nature. Law and order in the rural area, in the this Kisan, the labor, even they are also for Modi.
Okay, Joyta, Mayawati, game over in UP, 0 and nowhere to be seen, not really contesting, no big announcements happening, not really in the scene, game over?
Well, I don't really know about that, you know, because I'm hearing things like, say, for example, BSP is not that over, perhaps in Western UP, they have some kind of a hold still there over there. But at the same time, what is happening in certain seats, you know, Samajwadi Party and BSP, they have some kind of a similar voting vote bank when it comes to the Muslim community. So what is happening, I think, whatever they have fielded Muslim candidates, say for example, so what happens over there is that the vote may get split and BJP may be benefiting from that.
Okay.
But yes, at the same time, we have to see, say for example, what happens in a seat like Nagina, from where this Chandrasekhar Azad is fighting, whether he is able to cut into Mayawati's vote or not. You know, whether there will be new Dalit faces coming up in Uttar Pradesh, we have to see whether, because you see there are, she has been able to retain her vote bank.
Okay, all right, okay. So there is a vote bank, it might be different, but it says that the Congress is wiped out. Wiped out means thank you very much to Rai Bareilly after Amethi. Maybe there is still confusion in the party on what's going to happen. We heard Robert Atra says that he's, might have a hat in it, that whether that works out well or not, but there is confusion in the party right now, what's happening over there. The Mayawati factor, is it going to be a factor? It was a large party, not until very a long time ago. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, those are the figures. They're there at the bottom of your screens.
For more such videos, subscribe to the NewsX YouTube channel, hit the bell icon.